In this video, I'm going to show you the easiest way to transform your plain and boring backdrops into something amazing using overlays in Photoshop. Okay, let's do this. So I'll start by selecting my subject here. So I'm going to go to my tools here, and then I'm just going to left click on this icon here. If you're using the older version of Photoshop, you can just select the quick selection tool here and then select your subject like this. I'm using the newer version of Photoshop, so I'm going to right click and then I'm going to deselect this. I'm going to go back to my tools here, and then I'm going to select object selection here. On top here, I'm going to select subject here. So Photoshop is going to select the subject for me. So from here, I'm just going to hold control on Windows or command on a Mac. And then I'm just going to press C on the keyboard to copy my subject like this. So you won't see anything until you hold control or command and then press V on the keyboard to paste the layer like this. So from here, I'm going to go to my files, and then I'm going to drag this file and drop it here like this. So let me just place it where I want it to be. I'm just going to put it here. So if I want to rotate this file, I can just go outside here. You see the icon will change. So once you see that, you can rotate it however you want. So from here, I can just click here, or I can just press enter on the keyboard. So I want this ring to be behind my subject. So I'm going to go to my layers here. I'm just going to drag the overlay layer here. I'm just going to drag it down here. So it's now behind my subject here. I'm going to go back to my layers here. I'm going to make a copy of this overlay layer by dragging it and dropping it on this icon here. And then I'm going to move it on top here like this. So from here, I'm just going to hold control or command, and then I'm just going to press T on the keyboard. From here, I'm just going to make it a little bit bigger, maybe something like this. And then I'm just going to rotate it like this. So if you've learned something from this video, or if you just like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see more videos like this one, don't forget to subscribe and smash that bell icon so that when I put up my next video, you will be notified. Okay, let me just zoom out. Control or command minus on the keyboard like this. I think I'm okay with this. I'm just going to click on this icon here. What I'm going to do from here, I'm going to make a copy of this layer. I'm just going to drag it and drop it on this icon like this. I'm going to hold control or command. Then I'm going to press T on the keyboard like this. I'm going to zoom out like this, and then I'll drag this to make it a little bit bigger. Let me just rotate it to maybe somewhere here. From here, I'm just going to click on this icon. So what I'm going to do from here, I'm just going to press Ctrl or Command plus 0 on the keyboard like this. So with the layer copy tool selected, I'm going to go to Filter, Blur, and then I'm going to select the Gaussian Blur here. Okay, let me just move this guy here so that we can see what's happening. So what I'm trying to do now is create a convincing depth of field effect. So when the focus is on my subject, everything in the foreground and the background will appear out of focus. And to achieve this effect, I'm going to apply the Gaussian blur to these rings. So this layer here with this ring, I'm going to use the radius of 60 like this. And then I'm going to click OK here. So from here, I'm going to move to this ring here. So I'm going to go to my layers here, and then I'm going to select this layer here. From here, I'm going to go on Filter, Blur, and then I'm going to select the Gaussian blur here. Okay, let me just move this guy here so that we can see what's happening. So with this layer, I'm going to use the radius of 30, and then I'm going to click OK here. So this is our before, this is our after, this is our before, this is our after. How cool is this? So I'll put the link in the video description below to where you can download these overlays. I'm going to go to my layers here, and then I'm going to select the layer on top. I'm going to left click on it, and then I'm going to hold shift on the keyboard, and then I'm going to select the layer below it like this. From here, I'm just going to click on this group icon to put these layers in a group. So what I can do from here, I can just go on blend mode here and then go through the blend modes here. So if I want, I can select maybe the overlay blend mode, or I can just select the luminosity here. I'm going to select this layer. I'm going to go to blend modes here. I'm going to change it to luminosity here. So if I'm going for this type of a vibe, I can just export it like this. This is the before. This is the after. This is the before. This is the after. Or I can just go back to blend modes here and change it from luminosity to normal, and then select the group here and change the blend mode from luminosity to pass through like this. So let's say you don't like the overall colors here. You can just go on this circle, left click on it, and then select the use saturation here like this. Let's just move this guy here so that you can see what's happening. So from here, I'm just going to click on the clipping mask here so that whatever adjustments I'm going to make here, they're just going to be applied to this group here. So I can change it to any color that I want here. Okay, let me just select maybe this color. Let's say I want this same color to be applied to this layer here. So I'm going to drag and drop the hue saturation layer on this icon here. So from here, I'm just going to drag the hue saturation, the one on top here, and drop it inside here. So the effect will be everywhere, but I want this effect to just be applied to this layer here. So I'm going to go on the layer properties here, and then I'm just going to click on this icon here. If I want to change the color here, I can just go back in the hue saturation here and change it to maybe negative 40 here. Then I'm going to go back to the layer on top here. I'm just going to double click on it like this. Let me just change this number to negative 40 like this. This is the before. This is the after. This is the before. This is the after. So if you want to retouch fast and level up your retouching skills, you should check out my Beauty Retouching Actions Pack. The link will be in the video description below. And if you want to learn the simplest way to make the skin smooth in Photoshop, you should check this video here.